Welcome to Douglas on Trading. Today we're talking cumulative volume delta. Woo! Yeah! Cumulative volume delta! What's up, guys? Douglas on Trading. We're going to be talking the cumulative volume delta, and today it's specifically the NinjaTrader order flow cumulative volume delta. You would need a lifetime license to buy this on NinjaTrader. It's part of their order flow suite, and the order flow suite only comes with the lifetime license. So let's get into it. The first thing that we're going to need to know is what the hell is cumulative volume delta? Well, let's read what NinjaTrader has to say. So you track buying and selling pressure with order flow cumulative volume delta. So what is cumulative volume delta? Delta refers to the net difference between buying and selling volume at each price level. Cumulative delta builds upon this concept by recording a cumulative tally of these differences in buying versus selling volume. And this is important here. It's passive versus aggressive orders. For traders using the cumulative delta, limit orders are considered passive while market orders are considered aggressive. In other words, buying at the ask or selling at the bid are considered aggressive since these orders will fill immediately. This implies a sense of urgency in the market. With that in mind, the cumulative volume delta calculation uses the following formula: market buy orders minus market sell orders equals the delta. And so that's important. It's not limit orders, not the orders that are waiting in the book. Those are considered passive buyers and sellers. We're looking for the aggressive buyers and sellers. So they're the ones placing the market order. And once again, the cumulative delta is the market buy orders minus the market sell orders to get the delta. And one of the main uses of the cumulative delta indicator is to confirm or deny trends. And they give you a little chart here to show that this looks like a small trend working up. The cumulative delta is actually working down. So it looks like possibly sellers are actually in control. At least the aggressive sellers are in control. So that might mean that this is not a valid trend. Now, with the NinjaTrader options, there are two options. There's a session option and a bar option. I will show you both of these on the chart shortly. So the session option is this top display here. And so that is kind of the cumulative gathering. So if over time the market buys are winning over time, then this is going to be going up like you see over here to the left. And over time, if the sellers are winning, you're going to see it start going down like that. And then you can get a big picture view of what's happened throughout the day. Now, the other display option is the bar option, which does not do this whole cumulative collection over the day. It is just a cumulative collection of each price level. So if this is a 5-minute chart, then each bar here would represent a 5-minute bar on that chart. If it's a 200 tick chart, each one of these represents the 200 tick, so on and so forth. You get the idea. And so this just lays it out in a flat line. It kind of tells you, each individual bar, how aggressive that bar was with the buyers or sellers. That's really all we need to know to get started. And so remember what the main use of this are really twofold. What NinjaTrader says is to confirm market trends up or down. Another thing people use it for is to find divergence. And I will show you both of those. So what we have here is the ES. And what are we on? We're on the 5-minute. Let's get this up here like so. So we're on the, ES 5-minute chart. And I'm just going to take you through a number of days here and we'll find out what we can find out. First of all, you want to start, somewhere where there's actual volume. So you can see at the beginning of the day, this is the overnight trading. There's not much volume. So down below, it represents that there's not much volume going on. The cumulative delta would be virtually useless in that situation. So it really doesn't come in handy till about 8:30. And what you see here, we're currently set on the bid ask. Let's do that real quick, actually, now that I think about it. Let's look at the options for NinjaTrader. So these are the options. You've got the bid ask. So that's market buyers, market sellers hitting the bid and the ask. And that's what determines the delta. And then we've got it set on session. Now there's another one. We're not going to look at the up down, the uptick versus down tick, which is what this one is, up down tick. It's kind of like a bid ask, but it's going to give you a little bit different data. So this is when price ticks up or price ticks down. It's measuring that instead. I think the bid ask in theory is more accurate. I don't know. So that's up to you. There's no reason to look at both of them. So we're just going to look at the bid and ask on the session, and then I'll show you on the bar chart. And so we start out with this trend, and the cumulative delta is moving up basically in unison. It's moving across in unison. It's moving up in unison. So this isn't telling you basically anything. It's practically useless for that day. Just fine. We go to the next day, start around 8:30. We're moving up here. And you know what I found is for strong trending day, the delta, there's not much use for it. But when you get into a day like this, where you've got like double tops, you got ranges going on, then it can be slightly helpful to see what direction the market's going in. So, you know, it's moving in unison as it was on the previous day, and then it moves down in unison. But then we get here, and so this is where it could come in handy. And this is up to you. I mean, whether you want to use this tool as anything, it's simply an indicator. It's just some information that you need to use at your discretion in context with your particular strategy. So we're just trying to see if this might help your particular strategy at all. So as we go up, you know, what they were saying earlier is maybe you think this is an uptrend, but the delta in this case is not moving up at all. In fact, it's moving down. It's moving sideways. Let's mostly just moving sideways, but it is got a slight downtrend going on the delta. And on the chart, you've got the uptrend. So you're thinking maybe this isn't a valid up. And with this double top here, that would be the context where you say, maybe this is the area that I want to sell. It might make me feel better about taking that double top, that we're not going to have a breakout because there's not enough push from the buyers to make the breakout happen. Now, of course, anything in trading is not guaranteed. Things can change on a dime. But in that situation, on this particular day, it would have been helpful. Let's move to the next day. Ah, before I forget, this is also an indicator of divergence, right? Right? So we've got a top here and a top here. So as the market goes up, this goes down. That's what they mean by divergence. So you're not just confirming whether this trend is valid or not. In this situation on the divergence, you're saying, you know, these two things don't match up. So that's why I might want to be looking for sells instead of buys. So that's divergence. Let's go to the next day. Let's see if anything happens on this day. We've got, it's a very rough day. Up and down. Cumulative delta is moving practically in unison. So again, that's a day when it doesn't really come into play. Strong uptrend day, I said mostly on these days, is pretty useless. All that's doing is just going up with the trend. Doesn't show you anything there. And here we go. So we got another one of these range type days. Let's see if this will show us anything at all. It's pretty much moving in unison for the most part. We do get divergence. So this is a little sneakier divergence, right? It's a little harder to see, so we can go off the tips. Whether you want to go off the close or the tips, that's up to you. But what you're seeing here, the market's gone down and the cumulative delta is going down with it. And then it pops up a little bit. Cumulative delta pops up and it goes down and goes up, and cumulative delta is moving with it, except on the chart, you see that the chart moved past those previous lows. on the chart. We moved past the previous lows. We've come into the low of the day, but on the cumulative delta, we did not. On the cumulative delta, we actually made a higher low. So this is classic divergence in context. So you're at the low of the day, and that's where somebody might use the cumulative delta to confirm or disconfirm that they want to take this double bottom and go along with it. We get to the top, and then we've got kind of a smaller divergence after this. As you can see on the delta, you've got a top here, and that matches with the top on the chart. And then the delta moves back up with the chart, but it doesn't reach back up to the top the way the chart does. And so that's another small variation of divergence where somebody might be looking to use it as confirmation to go long or short. We'll do maybe one more day here, see if there's anything we can see. Chart's moving pretty much in unison there. Didn't see anything there. And that's pretty much just a strong downtrend that's confirmed by the cumulative delta. So not much going on there. So you can see that it's not something that you're going to be able to use all the time. You'll have to keep a lookout for those divergences or those rare areas where it can confirm or disconfirm the trend. Now, I personally don't use the cumulative delta, but I know there's a number of people out there that do. And so that is all up to you. So let's take a different look. Let's look at the bar real quick, just to get an idea what that looks like. We gotta wait for it to calculate. We need some Jeopardy music. There we go. So on the bar, you can see it's just a flat line, and this gives you a better view of the volume within the specific bars. So again, you would have to come up with kind of your own use for how that's going to play into your strategy, if it could play into your strategy at all. Again, it could be something just to confirm or disconfirm the trend. You see this going down, but it bounces around a little bit. And so maybe you're looking down at these bars and notice that the reds are obviously more dominant. I guess a good way to put it. The reds are more dominant than the greens or the buys. And so that might confirm your bias that we are going to continue heading down lower. Or when we hit this low and start moving up, you get these real solid buys going across here that might confirm in your mind that maybe we're ready for a reversal. Of course, the chart is showing you much of the same data. So I don't know how beneficial the bar version would be, but maybe you'd like it better. And we'll keep it short and simple. We'll go back to this day just to see if there's anything on the bar chart that might show you a divergence or anything like that. Don't know. We'll leave the bar up to you. We'll leave the bar session up to you. You can play with that on your own to figure it out. But I wanted to give you a quick overview of what a cumulative delta is, what it is with divergence, and how people use it. And again, this is the Ninja Trader order flow cumulative delta, but there are other indicators that do the same thing. You don't necessarily need the Ninja Trader one. That's it, boys. Good luck. Good trading.